On the Healthbeat this morning, the dangers of being a glutton this Thanksgiving. As we get ready to sit down to one of our most fattening meals of the year, I sat down with Dr. Barry Ramo to see how gorging yourself could create real health problems. Good morning, Dr. Ramo. Thanksgiving is upon us, and although we love to eat a bunch at Thanksgiving, there are some medical problems that are very serious that can come along with a big meal.
Well, Thanksgiving is a time even the healthiest person tends to pig out. The average study shows that 4,600 calories are about what you're going to take.
Wow.
And 225 grams of fat. That is a huge amount of fat, and it really is a stress test on your gallbladder as well as your cardiovascular system.
So what can happen to your body?
Well, here's what happens. If you take in a huge meal, there have been a number of studies on this. Number one is that people stress their gallbladder. That's kind of an exercise test for your gallbladder. It means that you need to put out more bile, and that if you have a propensity to getting a gallbladder attack, that's the time to do it. The second problem is the cardiovascular one. Eating a huge meal increases the output of your heart, the so-called cardiac output, and it diverts blood flow to your intestinal tract. That means that if you have a heart problem, there is some risk that you might decrease the blood flow to your heart. The other factor in these huge meals is that your blood tends to thicken, and when it thickens, it makes the risk of having a heart attack greater. The studies have been impressive. One study from Israel, and I know they eat, I was over in Israel last fall, they eat huge meals there sometimes, that these people had a sevenfold increase if they had a big meal of heart attacks compared to a smaller meal. So there is some health risk. Not telling people not to eat at all.
Of course, but the other thing is feeling really sleepy.
That's true. In fact, there's a thing called eating fatigue. And eating fatigue results not just from the tryptophan in the turkey, but also when you eat a lot, there's some depression of your alertness. And you combine that with alcohol, and you are a real danger on the road. So people need to recognize that that's a real potential risk.
All right, so what do you do?
Well, number one, don't eat with your hands. Studies
okay.
Studies have shown that if you eat with your hands, that you tend to eat a lot more.
Okay.
Number two, put your food on smaller plates.
Okay.
There was a study done on ice cream, for example. People who had ice cream on a smaller plate tended to eat less. Now, I know that no one is going to invite me to Thanksgiving dinner after this story, but I do think that eating a smaller amount makes good sense, particularly if you have some kind of cardiovascular problem.
Okay.
But I want everyone to have a very happy Thanksgiving.
So again, everything in moderation. Enjoy it. Just don't overindulge.
That's exactly right.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Ramo.
You bet.